The local representative for the Caribbean Association for Feminist Research and Action says the Canaries incident should come as no surprise. As far as she's concerned, too many children in St. Lucia are victims of sexual abuse, and the latest reports out of Canaries ought to be a wake-up call to hold perpetrators to account, especially when they have sworn to serve and protect.
One must seriously wonder, you know, who can you really trust if one who takes an oath to serve and protect and is quite fully aware, cognizant of those aspects of the law, then engages in child sexual abuse? It's very, very disturbing, and I think we really need to send that message of zero tolerance.
Mrs. Cherry believes there is adequate screening in place for new entrants to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, but she says members of the public must play their part in raising objections when the photographs of potential entrants are published in the newspapers to obtain their feedback. Human rights lawyer Martinez Francois, for his part, says the allegations that a policeman sexually abused a teenage boy in Canaries represents a serious blot on the entire force.
It's a shame and a disgrace on the police force. And then this idea of police keep investigating themselves, I think the chicken has come home to roost, because this is not the first time we're hearing about such police misbehavior and misconduct. I mean, there are a number of them. There was recently an accusation in the Marshall Police Station involving a policeman and a little boy. That was swept under the carpet. Up to now, we never know the outcome of that particular travesty. And then there was recently this four policemen that were accused of raping this young girl.
Mr. Francois says that matter involving the alleged police rape of a young girl was also swept under the carpet. If there was any consolation from the Canaries incident, the director of the Division of Human Services says it was the way the people of the community and an off-duty police officer responded after an alarm was raised.
And this is the kind of response we want from persons, from our St. Lucian persons, not to accept this kind of behavior, not to accept this kind of violation against our children and against citizens on the whole.
As far as Mrs. Lewis is concerned, the Canaries incident again raises the question of whether a name and shame list of persons found guilty of the sexual abuse of children should be considered for St. Lucia. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.